Hello students, welcome back to your science class. So students, in the previous class in this chapter, that is tissues, we were talking about the plant tissues and we have already completed with the plant tissues. We have seen what is the protective tissue, and protective tissues are what? Basically the name itself says that it is what? It is a help in protection, and that will include two things students. The first one is epidermis and the second one is the cork. Okay, so it help in the protection. Epidermis and cork cell both are helping in the protection itself. Epidermis is student, there are lot of other things also came out from the epidermis, like root hair is there, like lenticels are there, like stomata are there, even cutin. This is cuticle layer. Okay, this all are the present on the epidermal layer, on the epidermis. But overall its function is to protect the internal tissue. Second one is cork cell, and in case of a cork cell, they are also having in function in protection, and that will also protect the internal organ. And this cork cell, it is actually fireproof as well as insulated to water, and this will forms a layer over it, and which is also called as fluverine, and fluverine do not allow the gases or the water to pass through it. So this is how the protection or protective tissues can be described. Then we have started with the animal tissue, and animal tissues are basically classified into four types. First is epithelial, second is connective, then muscular, and then nervous. We have also seen that what is the origin and what is the function, basic function, overall function of the epithelial, connective, muscular, and nervous tissue. Let us start with the epithelial tissue student, and I told you the characteristic of the epithelial tissue, that the cells are very closely packed with each other. And if the cells are very closely packed to each other, what does that mean? It means there is no intracellular spaces are present there. No intercellular spaces are there. They are very closely attached with each other. As well as you will find that it is a continuous layer. If it is not a continuous sheet, if it is not having any kind of a space, it will be a continuous sheet. And you will find that between the cells, the cementing material is there which help them to join together. In case of epithelial tissue students, blood and lymph, both of them are absent, as well as the free surface is actually exposed to some fluid. So these are some of the characteristics of the epithelial tissue. One more thing is there student, that the cell layer or the epithelial tissue, the layer of the tissue is present on a basement, on a pavement membrane, which we call as a basement or as a pavement membrane. So let me write the point that the cell of epithelium The cell of epithelial tissue cell of epithelial tissue are placed over a thin extracellular fibrous membrane. Fibrous membrane called basement membrane. Okay, so these are some of the characteristics of the epithelial tissue. Now the epithelial tissue is also divided into squamous epithelium, columnar epithelium, then ciliated epithelium, then glandular epithelium, and stratified epithelium. although the stratified and a simple epithelium, the broadly classified into two, that is simple and stratified, and the simple one again divided into squamous and columnar and cuboidal. And here also the same thing, and in the cuboidal and columnar is also divided into ciliated and glandular. The division is like that, but here we are going to study overall together that what are the different kind of epithelium, because in the higher section we will going to study in the detail about this epithelial tissue. So let us start with the first one, student, and try to understand the first type of epithelial tissue, which is simple squamous epithelial tissue. The first one is simple, or we can write here squamous epithelium itself. Squamous epithelium. What happened in the squamous epithelium here? So the first point, that it is also called as pavement membrane. Actually, it is very much flat like a structure. It's like a pavement only. It's a very thin flat structure, and that is why it is called as the squamous epithelium. So it is also called as pavement membrane, called as pavement membrane. Then it is very thin and form delicate lining. Okay, it is very thin and it forms the delicate lining. Then in this type of epithelium, you will look what are the cells. They are flat and they are arranged again very close to each other. Okay. In this type of epithelium, the cells are flat, these cells are flat and are arranged very close to each other, close to each other like tiles of floor, Okay, so it is also called as a pavement membrane, and it looks like a tiles of the floor, and they are very compactly arranged with each other. They are very thin and flat. So this is the kind of a structure that they have. Let us see what is the location of this squamous epithelium, as well as what is its role at that particular location. So location is these cells are found in the wall of blood vessel, in the wall of the blood vessel that is endothelium. Wall of the blood vessels, that is endothelium. Lining of body cavity, lining of body cavity, which is and esophagus, Bowen's capsule, Bowen's capsule, then nephron, taste buds, nephron, taste buds, lung alveoli, lung alveoli. Lung alveoli, eyelids. Okay, so these are present at the blood vessels, that is at the endothelium. Then lining of the body cavity, then it is also present at the esophagus, the lining of the esophagus. Bowen's capsule is a capsule which is found in the nephron, students. So there it is also present. It is also present in the nephron, it is present at the taste bud, and the lining of the alveoli. Alveoli, you know that, where the exchange of the gases can take place in the lungs. And finally, it is also present at the eyelid. So these are the location of the squamous epithelium. Now let us see what is the function of this squamous epithelium. Function. Function, students, its role is protection, help in exchange, help in diffusion, in the process of diffusion. Diffusion. Protection and diffusion. These are the two roles of the squamous epithelium. So I hope you have understood the squamous epithelium. Now let us start with the next kind of epithelium, student, which we call as a cuboidal epithelium. Cuboidal epithelium. In case of a cuboidal epithelium, when you look at the structure, student, you will find that these appear as a cube like a structure, and they are very closely packed with each other. Okay, likewise they are arranged with each other and having a nucleus in it. In it, the cytoplasm also. Cytoplasm are also present. It looks like a cube, like a structure will be there. That is why your name is given as a cuboidal epithelium. Okay, so we can write here about the cuboidal epithelium. That is epithelium. Or cube shaped. Epithelium are of cube shape. Then next one is lining of germ layer. Location, lining of, it is present as lining of germ layer. Germ layer in germinal epithelium, gametes. Germ layer, lining of germ layer. Then
glands like thyroid, thymus, ciliary body, layer of eye, epithelial layer of retina, So it is generally cube shaped structure, and these are responsible, these are basically present location is present at the germ layer, it is present in the glands like thymus, and the thyroid gland lining is done with the cuboidal epithelium. Then it is also present at the layer of eye, it is also present at the epithelial layer of the retina. So this is the location of the cuboidal epithelium. Now what is the function? Function is protection, absorption, secretion. These all will be done with the help of the cuboidal epithelium. Absorption, protection, then secretion, excretion, then reproduction. So in all the places we will find that the cuboidal epithelium is present, cube like epithelium is present there. Okay, now let us move on and we will see the next kind of epithelium student, which is called as columnar epithelium. Structure of the columna, the name is given columnar because it is like a column. When you look at the structure, you will find that it is like a column. So here since it looks like a column, it's a column like a structure student, and that is why it is called as a columnar epithelium. Although there is another layer and which consisting of a cilia from it, a lot of our cilia will also came out through the columnar epithelium, and even not only this, but glands are also present there in the columnar epithelium. When you look at the structure, sometimes a lot of a different kind of a glands are also attached with it. So that is the another name we will give to it. But here what we have to understand is the columnar epithelium, and the name columnar is given because it is a column shaped structure. Now let us see that what is the columnar epithelium, what is its location as well as its function. So the cells are elongated. The cells are elongated and placed side by side. Placed side by side, similar to column. Thank you.
These cells are elongated and they are placed side by side, similar to a column.
What is the location? Location, lining of stomach. In the lining of stomach, bile duct then lining of intestine, PCT of nephron. What is a PCT, student? Actually, full form of a PCT is a proximal convoluted tubule. Proximal convoluted tubule is the tubule which is present in the nephron, but you simply have to understand that in this tubule the columnar epithelium is present. Now let us see what is the function of the columnar epithelium in these location. So the role of the columnar is it help in secretion. So the function of the columnar epithelium is what it is. Its function is secretion, absorption, and protection. Okay, so its role is secretion, its role is absorption as well as protection. These are what? These are some of the functions of the columnar epithelium. So this is what, this is also an another kind of a epithelium, student. Let us see the next epithelium, and that is ciliated epithelium. In case of a ciliated epithelium, this is the, I told you like in case of a columnar also, students, you have seen, if we see it like, so here also, if these are the column-like structure in which the nucleus are present, and in the nucleus, you will find that there are the cilia present over it. So these cilia are not only present on the columnar but also present on the cuboidal also. So such kind of epithelium is called as a ciliated epithelium. Actually, when it is present on the cuboidal, we will call it ciliated cuboidal epithelium. When it is present at the cuboidal, we will call it ciliated columnar. Present on the columnar, we will say the ciliated columnar epithelium. Let us see the ciliated epithelium. So here, this epithelium consists of cells which bear cilia on their outer surface. Cilia on their outer surface. These cells may be cubical or columnar. It means if it is present on the columnar, it will be this columnar ciliated epithelium. If it is not, then it is cuboidal ciliated epithelium. What is the location? Location is respiratory tract. OVO Lowry duct, respiratory tract, oviduct, internal ear, internal ear, lining of uterus, spinal cord. These are what, these are some of the location of the ciliated epithelium. Now let us see what is the function. So its function is it maintains the flow of various substance that come in its contact this is the ciliated epithelium. Now let us see another kind of epithelium, which is called glandular epithelium. It means the epithelium which consisting of a glands inlet. Glandular epithelium. Here, the organ or epithelial tissue or the epithelial tissues which secretes some chemical substance. Which secretes some chemical substance are composed of glandular epithelium. What is the location? Basically, it is present at all the inner lining of the glands. Inner lining of all the type of gland. Then function of secretion of enzymes. Then hormones, chemical substance, mucus, milk, etc. Okay, so it basically helps in the secretion of the enzymes, in the hormones, some of the chemical substances, mucus, milk. These all will be secreted with the help of the glandular epithelium. The gland means it is basically present at the inner lining. So obviously that will help in the
function also, and this is some of the function of the glandular epithelium. Other kind, that is the last type of epithelium student, which is also called a stratified epithelial tissue. There is no difference. Stratified is actually not a one layer, but it will include a many layer. So stratified. Stratified epithelium, many layer of the cells are placed over one another. It means there are many layer of the cells are there in case of a stratified.